Hi, let us understand how to configure the configuration file to support the storage backend. There are n number of storage backends supported for HashiCorp Vault, and depending on the requirement like high availability or support provided by the HashiCorp, I can choose any of these storage backend. We will be having detailed discussion on various storage backend and what are all the options and features available within each. Before getting into the details, we will get started quickly by using the file system, that is the simple storage option where all the data will get stored as a part of the file system. Let me make the configuration file. Let me edit the configuration file, that is myconfig.hcl. Here I do have the details for storage, listener and other parameters. Storage stanza, it's going to have the type as file, and the path, it's going to mention where it's going to get stored. The data folder will get created once I initialize the vault, and listener, I'm going to have the addresses, localhost IP address and the port 8200. This is the default value, and this is what going to control the HashiCorp vault will be listening only from the localhost. Let's not make any change to this. Now I'm going to configure the storage to get stored in the file system in this specific folder. Now I'm going to start the server with the command vault server, and then provide the configuration file with the parameter -config and path to the configuration file. The server will get started, and it's going to display the various configuration it used to start the server. Now let me provide the vault option and see what's going to be the output. I'm going to list what are all the secrets available within the vault. If you remember, in the earlier discussion, we were starting the server in the developer mode. So automatically it will get initialized and it will be in the unsealed state, and I can go ahead and use it as it is. Since I disabled the TLS certificate and the server is listening in the port HTTP, I need to set the vault address explicitly. Let me export the environmental variable vault address and the localhost IP address and port 8200. Now let me list the secrets within the vault using the command vault secret list. It's giving the error message because the vault, it is in the sealed state. Sealing is nothing but it's not going to allow any operation against that particular vault or the storage engine. And as a first thing, I need to initialize the vault. Initializing is nothing but preparing the storage backend to receive the data. And it's going to generate in-memory master key, which will be used to lock the data which are stored within the vault. And to provide the master key to the user, it's going to use something called Shami's secret sharing algorithm. We will be having a detailed discussion on what this particular Shami's secret algorithm and the purpose of master key being stored only in the memory. We will be having a detailed discussion on initialize vault operator. Now let me go ahead and do the initialization and show how things are going to work. So the command is vault operator init. It's going to provide 5 unsealed keys. Out of these 5 keys, I need to use any 3 keys to unseal the vault. So we need to understand about what is vault initialization, what is sealing and unsealing. For further discussion, I'm going to copy this particular value and keep it safe. With any of this particular value, I can go ahead and unseal the vault. Without unsealing, I cannot use the vault. Now I have initialized the vault and the storage is ready to store the data, but I cannot do any operation against the vault. I cannot read or I cannot write. For that I need to unseal the vault. And by default, vault will be in the sealed state. Before getting detailed into the vault, we need to have in-depth understanding on vault initialization, seal and unseal operator. Let's have a detailed discussion and come back to the same vault and unseal them and do the operations within the vault. So in a quick summary, we learned about how to configure the configuration file to use the file system as the storage, and introduce the concepts of vault initialization, seal and unseal.